I'm Ellen Derrick. I'm one of the certified financial planners for LearnVest Planning Services. And one of the questions we get a lot is, should I be investing? Is it right for me? Is this a good time? And this is definitely a good question to be thinking about at the beginning of the year as you're reassessing all of your financial goals. And so we want to make sure that you're on track for all of your other goals first before you really tackle investing outside of your retirement account. Right, Brandy?
Exactly. As long as you have a fully funded emergency savings, you're on track for retirement, you have zero credit card debt, at that point you can think about potentially investing for goals that are at least 5 years away. So goals like saving for college, buying a home, these are all things that you can be putting money aside. Anything sooner than that, you're really not going to want to put it, and you're really not going to want to invest it because you really don't want to take that market risk.
And as Brandy said, you always want to make sure that you're not investing any money that's for any goals that are sooner than 5 years in the future. Because you really want to make sure that you don't have to delay any of your goals if you don't have enough money set aside and the stock market has dropped.
Yeah, unfortunately, we give up the opportunity to earn a higher rate of return in exchange for liquidity. And anything that you have saved for short-term goals or for emergency savings especially, you need to make sure that money is liquid and available.
So as you get closer to needing the funds for that goal, whether it be buying a home or sending your kid to college, you're going to want to start moving that amount that you'll need for that particular year into cash. That way you're not forced to liquidate your funds in the event the market goes down, and then you're really locking in your losses, meaning at that point you're not giving it a chance to go back in the market and grow. So as you get closer to that goal, potentially maybe a year away, you might want to start moving that into cash or CDs. That way you're still earning a little bit higher return, a high yield savings account, but you're not taking that market risk.
Now, and speaking of market risk, one of the things people ask is, you know, should I rebalance my portfolio? The economy's been crazy. It went up. It went down. Now, what should I do? And emotion plays a big factor in that. You know, if you've ever heard the old saying, buy low and sell high, it's actually a real saying. It's something you should do, but it's so hard to do. And what it means is you should buy investments when they're cheap, when prices are down. You should sell your investments when they're high and you can take a profit. The difficulty with that is that it goes against what we feel like doing as humans. We get really excited when prices go up and we feel like we should buy more. And then when things go down, we feel horrible about it and we want to sell those things out of our portfolio. And that's really the opposite of what we should do. So rebalancing is a really good way to make that automated. Once you set your allocation for your portfolio, as long as no other factors have changed that would change whether or not that allocation is appropriate, then what you should do is sell the things that have made a little bit of a profit to get back to your original allocation, and then invest more in the things that have had a little bit of a rough year, knowing that they're probably on their way back up again.